Coming up next from San Fran Freak Show, the Savage Nation, from Talk 910 KNEW.
On the air, online, and on the go, this is Talk 910 KNEW.
Warning. The Michael Savage Show contains adult language, adult content, psychological nudity. Listener discretion is advised.
America's most exciting radio talk show, The Savage Nation. Here is Michael Savage.
That the Republican Party leadership in the Congress has made a decision that they want to try to deny President Obama success, which means, in my mind, they're rooting against the country as well. So they voted against the stimulus bill.
Stop Nostrilman, right there. Hold it. Don't play the next piece. That's Representative Henry Nostrilman, the man with the nose that looks as though it's been in the wrong places for so many years that it has been distorted into that of less than an anteater. Listen to what this man just said. Those who oppose Obama are voting against America. So this wonderful, advanced politician, reprehensible Waxman, says that anyone who believes in a two-party system is voting against America. I want you to think about how demented this man is to believe we should have everyone saluting a dictator. Now play the next one. It gets even worse.
We're into the popular culture now, and Michael Jackson was a great, great performer, and lots of sadness there for many reasons. What I have said to my colleagues over the years, and certainly as leader and as speaker, is that there's an opportunity on the floor of the House to express their sympathy or their praise anytime that they wish. I don't think it's necessary for us to have a resolution.
Well, that's interesting. She actually did the right thing. She did not cater to Representative Sheila Jackson Lee, who wanted Congress to actually pass a memorial resolution to the pervert and the drug addict, Michael Jackson. Even Pelosi came to her senses. Somebody must have advised her properly when they realized that most of America detested the orgy of trumped-up sadness. Play I'm the Great Pretender, please, in honor of Waxman and the Demon Cats of the Savage Nation.
I'm the Great Pretender.
Care about you? Do you think they even know what America is? Do you think a guy like Representative Henry Waxman, whose nose is so distorted from all the years that it's been in the wrong places, he actually ever thinks about what's good for America? Do you actually think that Nancy Pelosi ever thinks about what would be good for America and her grandchildren? Do you actually think any of these people think beyond immediate power grabs? I don't personally, frankly. Not at all. But it gets worse now. It gets worse now. We go now to the bottom of the barrel on the Demon Cat side. The most extremist of them all is Senator Chuck Schumer, who wants to pass amnesty for illegal aliens and jam it down your throat. Listen to clip 02.
And the very first thing I'll tell the president is something that I think will sound familiar. When the president asks me whether Congress can pass comprehensive immigration reform this Congress, I will smile and say, Mr. President, yes, we can.
Isn't that nice? Well, Schumer, let me tell you something. You're not only a fool, you're a liar. You're a liar because you have the nerve to say that they come here not for the benefits, but for the jobs. What jobs are they coming here for, Schumer, you liar? Listen to clip 4.
I will tell you that the employer sanction parts of the bill, which are the most important to stopping the flows of future illegal immigration.
Oh, yeah, in the
because
future.
Despite what some
you lying pig.
Illegal immigrants are coming here for benefits. They're not. They're coming for jobs.
Now, wait a minute. We have a job meltdown in America, and this liar from Brooklyn This liar from Brooklyn says they're not coming here for benefits, they're coming for jobs. Schumer, you're a liar. And let me tell you something, everybody knows it. You're not going to get away with this, Schumer. You may call me any name you want. You may say that commentators are going to try to gin up anger against it. You are a fool if you think that this is going to get through without a fight. You're wrong, Schumer. Everybody knows that the jobs that they had are gone and that American workers are displaced. There are no jobs at the lower end. And they do come here for the freebies. Fact, Schumer, most Americans know that one-third of all prisoners in America are illegal aliens. Now, if they've all come here for jobs, Chuck, how come they wind up in the slammer? It's because, what, they can't get any more benefits, so they join a gang and they shoot people, and if we only gave them more, they wouldn't join a gang? I've heard that liberal claptrap my whole life. I don't believe a word of it. 1-800-449-8255, michaelsavage.com. So anyone who doesn't agree with Obama is an enemy of America. So in other words, we should have a Stalin where there's a one-party system. KNEW, Jerry, you're on the Savage Nation. Go ahead, please.
Mr. Savage, actually, it's Jay from San Francisco. And some things, once again, I agree with you on some things. Some things I don't agree with you on. No, everyone shouldn't agree with Obama. I didn't agree with Bush. But the key is if you want, as Rush Limbaugh said, if you want Obama to fail, then you obviously want the country to fail. Now,
Whoa. First of all, I'm not here to defend or attack Rush Limbaugh. He put his foot in his mouth with that one. You can't accuse me of having said that, can you?
Say it again, sir?
You can't accuse me of having said I want Obama to fail, can you?
No, I don't believe I've heard you say that, but I'd like to make one point.
No, I never said that. But the fact of the matter is he's failing because he's a far-left radical. So we don't need to help him fail. This man is a radical left-wing president. He was the most radical senator in U.S. history. You're telling me he's ruling from the center?
Okay, sir. First of all, I think you have to give him the full term of 4 years to determine whether he's a failure.
If I let this man pass what he wants to pass personally as a talk show host and said nothing for 4 years, there wouldn't be a country and I wouldn't have a talk show. He would eliminate free speech. You know that and I know that. So let's not be naive about this, Sam, Jay.
Sir, I would just like to comment on the stimulus money, if I may.
So you're moving all over the map. Now, you're moving on to the next topic now that you solved the other two. Stimulus money, go ahead, please.
Sir, you have states like South Carolina and Texas who are turning down Obama's stimulus money. These states need that stimulus money to balance their budget, to keep teachers...
Why are they turning down the money, Jay? It's because the money doesn't come without strings attached. Is that correct?
Why? Let me tell you why.
No. Let me tell you something. You're talking fast, but you're not listening. Why would a state turn down money that it so desperately needs?
Sir.
It is because it comes with strings attached. It makes the state more dependent upon Uncle Sam, meaning Uncle Obama, and it makes the state less independent. Don't you understand that?
What? Hello?
All right, take a walk. I've had enough of you. I don't care how many times you say, sir, don't call my show again. You lower the IQ of the show. End of story. Wait, what? The minute I say something already, you try the game of what? Do me a favor, play some music. It's Thursday. I'm looking at ads for fat loss.
They call me the wanderer.
I just lost 185 pounds of Corker fat in one button press. What's that picture of Obama looking at the girl's butt on the drug? Did you see that picture yet? Thank God, actually. I feel better. He's standing there at the G8 summit, and he's taking a look at a girl going by right there. Great. I got to tell you, whoever got this picture, this is good. This is good. It allays, let us say, at least in one area I can relate to the guy, you know. And Sarkozy's known as being a hound himself. Look at him smirking there. 1-800-449-8255. Wake up and fly right. So Schumer wants amnesty for 30 million illegal aliens. Obama releases the enemy. Did you hear about that one? Oh, you didn't make it to your local newspaper? You didn't hear about the 5 Iranian terrorists who were trying to kill U.S. troops who were captured by our men in Iraq in 07, kept since 07, BBC reporting that 5 Iranian murderers held by the U.S. military in Iraq have just been released because of Barack Hussein Obama. I suppose he will be getting an Iranian prize for a hero of the Soviet Revolution. I'll be right back.
These guys are so hilarious. I almost drive off the road every morning.
Armstrong and Getty. Weekday morning, 6 to 10. Talk 910 KNEW.
Well, Pelosi did something right, first time in her political career. She killed the controversial Michael Jackson resolution. That is right. The genius Sheila Jackson Lee, the genius congressperson from Texas, tried to pass a resolution honoring Michael Jackson, pedophile,